Hi Ben. Well, flooding is causing major disruption across parts of eastern Scotland right now. One of the worst affected areas here in Angus. You can see roads not passable, actually. And looking at the weather picture, we've seen 74 millimetres of rain fall across parts of eastern Scotland. That was in 24 hours, but the rain continues to come down very heavily. And indeed, the Met Office have extended the amber severe weather warning for heavy rain across Aberdeenshire, Angus and Perthingham Ross. It's now valid and enforced until 9 o'clock this evening. By the time the rain finally stops falling, we're looking at accumulations of around 100 to 150 millimetres of rain. And just in the last few moments, SEPA, the Scottish Environment Protection Agency, have issued 5 severe flood warnings. They're all enforced for Aberdeenshire, but that is where flooding's expected and poses a significant threat to life. Actually, for the rest of the UK, it's a bright enough day. Sunshine, a few showers, temperatures close to average for the time of year. But as I say, flooding is the major concern in Scotland. Some of the impacts, well, trains, ScotRail saying major disruption on the network across the east. The roads, a number of A roads closed. There are lane closures also on some of Scotland's motorways. So the message loud and clear is check before you travel and perhaps postpone your travel. Temperatures actually a little bit below average. Now, we have got a lot more rain to come into next week as well. The rain, though, will be accompanied by westerly winds, so the northeastern river catchments probably not seeing further flooding issues, but with the ground saturated in the south, we're going to need to watch for further flooding issues here.
Good afternoon. Finally, we have some more settled conditions. We've seen some sunshine today and there's more this afternoon in the form of sunny spells. A little bit more in the way of patchy cloud, however. Now, overnight Saturday, we've got a band of heavy rain sweeping through. That clears as we head through Sunday morning. Some showers for the morning, then sunny spells. It is going to be breezy, though, as we head through Sunday. Now, it's going to be a chilly night, too, as we head overnight Sunday into Monday. Temperatures again in low single figures and staying unsettled into next week.
Hello there. Very good evening to you. Today across the capital we have seen some spells of sunshine after the deluge of rainfall over the last few days, a little respite at least, but for the weekend a story well of two halves. Still Saturday seeing some spells of sunshine, although feeling rather chilly saying that, and by Sunday we see that return to something wetter with heavy blustery showers.
You know, today actually it's been all about the rainfall in Scotland. Here's the radar from the last few hours. The amber warning from the Met Office is still in force for the next 3 hours or so, 2.5 hours. The most amount of rainfall actually fell where pretty much the forecast was, around Char. 140 millimetres of rain in just 2 days. That is a lot of water, so hence we've got disruption across that part of the country. But for many of us, the weekend's actually not looking so bad. Saturday, we've got some sunshine on the way, and then on Sunday, I think quite a few showers. We'll be in between weather systems tomorrow. This weather system you can see in the Atlantic here, that is heading our way, and we'll be sweeping across the country during the course of Saturday night. So yeah, it's going to be mixed this weekend, but I think overall, actually not too bad. We'll certainly have some sunshine. In fact, let's put it this way. I think it'll be dry and bright more than it'll rain. We'll call it a chilly start tomorrow with some sunny spells. So if you're an early bird, you really will notice the chill in the air. There's Saturday, 11 o'clock. You can see it's pretty clear. Now, Sunday's going to be a little bit different. Sunday, we're going to call it a wet start early morning, especially for the shift workers. So if you're up very early, around about 5, 4, 5, 6 o'clock in the morning, it is not going to be pleasant. I mean, look at this. All of that rain, all the way across the capital, sweeping towards the east.
Hello. Friday has brought us some major disruption across parts of eastern areas of Scotland on account of severe flooding problems. This was one of our Weather Watcher photos coming in from Angus, which had been one of the worst to hit areas, along with Aberdeenshire, Perth and Kinross as well. Now, we've seen 140 millimetres of rain in places over the last 48 hours, and that rain has been causing big problems with flooding. We've seen around 7 severe flood warnings being issued by the Scottish Environment Protection Agency. That's where flooding is expected and brings with it a significant threat to life.
Now, the weather may be a bit drier for some of us, but it is turning cold and will get colder over the next few days. Becky is at Windsor Great Park for us this evening. And Becky, it's looking quite the light show behind you there.
Yes. Welcome to Windsor Great Park. This is an incredible 2-kilometre trail that takes you through the grounds forests of Windsor Great Park. And as you can see, it's completely magical. So it really is, as I say, absolutely gorgeous. The walk takes about an hour and a half and includes magical stag holograms, a fairy disco, and of course, the big man himself. And naturally, there's hot chocolate and marshmallows roasting en route. It's now open every single evening until the 2nd of January, closed only on Christmas Day. And in that time, they're expecting around 100,000 visitors. Now, you really can't fail to feel festive as you're walking around this incredible park. And it certainly helps that the temperatures have started dropping off. It was only last Sunday that we had temperatures recorded over 21 degrees. We're in November, people, over 21 degrees last Sunday. Remember, it was our warmest Remembrance Sunday on record. Temperatures have really taken a dive, and of course we've had all that rain as well. In fact, there is the possibility that some parts will get snow tomorrow night, but just to manage expectations, we're talking fairly normal snow, and that is snow across the highest points over the northern parts of the UK. But even so, temperatures definitely starting to drop. Tonight, Northern Ireland is likely to see its coldest night of the season so far, with temperatures dropping well below the seasonal average. So generally speaking, we are moving towards that slightly more festive feel, and things certainly getting a little bit nippy over the next few days. So it's a west-east split as we look ahead to tomorrow and the all-important weekend forecast. The best conditions will be across the west of the UK. And then looking on to Sunday, well, we are expecting to be quite a miserable start across the eastern parts, but then it's a mixture of sunny spells and showers on Sunday. Generally, most of those showers are going to be once again towards the west. So definitely more of the wet stuff to come over the next few days and as we look ahead to next week. But as Rudolph would say, don't worry, it's only rain, dear. Get it? Back to you.
Becky, thank you. I thought you were going to sing me a Christmas song, but maybe next week.